in the previous lecture of the television, we have discussed about the composite video signal. Composite video signal contains the video information. In television, we know that we have two types of the information. One is called a picture information. And another is a sound information. Whatever the picture information is there, it is converted into a composite video signal. And the sound information is converted into a audio signal. This composite video signal is a frequency modulated, because this information, both the information, we have to transmit it, and for the transmission we require a kind of a modulation. Already you know what is the importance of the modulation, but the video information is there. This video information is a amplitude modulated, and the audio information is a, so the two different information is modulated in a different way. So video signal is amplitude modulated and the audio signal is frequency modulated. Now here, if you see the inner amplitude modulation, already you know in amplitude modulation we have a carrier. When this carrier is modulated with a modulating signal, then it is generating a AM wave. Now this AM wave, it is containing a carrier frequency plus upper side band plus a lower side band. So the two side band frequency is going to be generated. Here if we see the picture information, then the video signal is there. The bandwidth of the video signal itself is a 5 megahertz. Here, if we are talking about this, then the bandwidth of the video signal is a 5 megahertz. Sometimes it can be a 5 to 6 megahertz also. The bandwidth of a audio signal is 20 kilohertz, because the maximum frequency in audio information is a 20 kilohertz. So after the modulation, whatever the bandwidth is there, this bandwidth in amplitude modulation, this bandwidth is a 2 FM. So here we are talking about a amplitude modulated wave. Then this amplitude modulated wave has the bandwidth equal to 2 FM. And in case of the video signal, here it will be a 2 into a 5 megahertz. So you require a bandwidth of a 10 megahertz. Okay? This 10 megahertz contain a carrier frequency as well as the upper side band and the lower side band. So let us see what is the frequency spectrum of a amplitude modulated wave. Here let us have a line where my video information is this. You can say the video signal, and this video information has a bandwidth of a 5 MHz. Now this video information is going to be modulated with the carrier. So here we require a picture carrier frequency. This picture carrier frequency is modulated with this, and it is generating a upper sideband frequency like this, as well as it is generating the lower sideband. So this is my picture carrier. Sometimes it is also known as a PC. And this is your a upper sideband and the lower sideband. So here if you see what is the total bandwidth of a amplitude modulated wave, then this bandwidth will be a 2 FM and that will be a 10 MHz. So if you want to transmit a picture carrier frequency of a one particular channel, then the required bandwidth is 10 MHz. This bandwidth is somewhat a larger bandwidth. It is occupying a large area of your frequency spectrum. Now here, we know that whatever the information is in the upper sideband, the same information is also in a lower sideband. Now if the bandwidth of the channel is large, then the number of the channel will be reduced, because we have limited area of a frequency spectrum. Whatever the electromagnetic spectrum is there, in that electromagnetic spectrum for the television transmission, some particular frequency range is allocated. And in this range, if you want to increase the number of the channel for the transmission, then we have to reduce the bandwidth. And this bandwidth can be reduced either by transmitting a upper sideband or a lower sideband, because both the sideband frequency is containing the same information. So to reduce the bandwidth of a television transmitter or the signal, then here we are using a vestigial sideband transmission. What is a vestigial sideband? That one of the sideband is completely transmitted. At the same time, the some portion of a other sideband is also transmitted with the carrier frequency. So the picture carrier frequency will be there. Here in a television, the upper sideband is completely transmitted. This whatever the information is here, it is going to be transmitted, and the same information is here. But we don't require this. So some portion of this is going to be transmitted, and vestigial part. Vestigial part means the somewhat part of the lower sideband. So here, this part of the lower sideband is transmitted along with the upper sideband. So here if you see that now the required bandwidth of the channel is reduced here. So the new bandwidth of the channel is this. And normally this bandwidth is of a 7 MHz. So this is known as a vestigial type transmission. This is one of the techniques of a amplitude modulated wave. Now, how much portion of the lower side brain is transmitting? It is also standard. Here in India, we are using a CCIRB system. And in CCIRB system, that everything is defined, that how much portion of the lower side brain, how much portion of the upper side brain is transmitting. Now, along with this, also we have to transmit a sound information. And the sound information is a frequency modulated wave. Its bandwidth is 20 kilohertz. And when it is frequency modulated, then the required bandwidth will be hardly a 100 kilohertz. So that carrier frequency is introduced after this video information or after the upper side band. And here you can see that this can be introduced like this. So after completing this, here we have a sound carrier frequency. And after the sound carrier, this sound carrier frequency requires a very small amount of the bandwidth. Remember. So here if you see, then this bandwidth is very small. Like this, hardly it is a 100 to 100 kilohertz is there. So it is not occupying a more space on a frequency spectrum. Then after, in the frequency spectrum, we have a gap. So between these two, there is no information. It is known as a safeguard. And then whatever the next range is there, here, the another channel information is going to be there. So this is about a channel one, you can say. Then the next channel will be there. And then we have a third channel will be there. So in this way, the picture carrier frequency and the sound carrier frequency is introduced in a transmission. Now let us see actually that what is the difference between the picture carrier frequency and the sound carrier frequency, how much portion of the lower side band is introduced. So let us see. You can see this diagram where my picture information or the picture carrier frequency is this. This is my completely a upper side band. You can say this is the upper side band. And this portion is a lower side band. This portion is a lower side band. How much portion of the lower side band is introduced? That is from a 0 to 1.25 megahertz. Remember, wherever your lower side band is started, or we have filtered out, that actually the lower side band is this completely in this way. But this part is going to be filtered out. And we consider a 1.25 megahertz of a lower side band. And in the upper part, if you see, it is only a 0.75 megahertz. So this portion is a 0.75 megahertz, and this portion is a 1.25 megahertz. Then we have a sound carrier frequency. At the end of the upper side band, the sound carrier frequency is introduced. But this one is a frequency modulated wave. Remember, this is my FM. And it also has some bandwidth. But this bandwidth is very small. So it is occupying a very small space here. That you can see, this much bandwidth is there. And what you have to remember that the difference between the picture carrier frequency and the sound carrier frequency is 5.5 megahertz. Sound carrier frequency is always higher than the picture carrier frequency by amount of a 5.5 megahertz. So now, if we see that 1.25 megahertz plus 5.5 megahertz, so at the end of the sound carrier frequency, your bandwidth is up to a 6.75 megahertz. And then we have a space of a 0.25 megahertz. Remember, after the 6.75 and a 7 megahertz, there is no information. Here, yeah, no information is there. Then it is known as a guard band. Guard band means that there is a separation between the two channels, so that there will not be a kind of a interference of the information. So here, nothing is going to be transmitted. And then, whatever the next channel will be there, it will be transmitted like this. So now if you calculate the total bandwidth, the total bandwidth will be a 7 megahertz. So in a CCIRB system, remember, here we use, in India, we have a CCIRB system where the channel bandwidth is of a 7 megahertz. This includes the picture information plus the sound information. So let us say we have one of the channel. Here we are talking about the channel 5. Because the number of the channels are there, I will give you the information about that. Let us say we are talking about the channel 5. Then for the channel 5, what is the frequency range? The frequency range is 174 megahertz to a 181 megahertz. Remember. So here if you see the difference, that is a 7 megahertz. Now what is the meaning of this? That 174 megahertz, that is the starting of a channel 1, a channel 5, means this portion is a 174 megahertz. Now in this 174 megahertz, if we add a 1.25 megahertz, that will give you the position of your picture carrier frequency. So, the picture carrier frequency is a 175.25 megahertz for the channel 5. Now, for the channel 5, what is the sound carrier frequency? So, if we have a 5.5 megahertz in this picture carrier, that will give you a sound carrier frequency. So, sound carrier frequency will be here. Here, whatever the sound carrier frequency is there, it is a 175 plus, so it is a 180.75 megahertz. That is a sound carrier frequency for the channel 5. And then, what will be the position of the channel 6? So, the channel 6, here, it is going to be start with this 181 megahertz. Because we have to add a guard band of 8.25 gigahertz. So 180.75 plus 181 plus 0.25 megahertz. So your next channel will start with the frequency of 181 megahertz. So in this way, when you are talking about a one particular channel, then what will be the picture carrier frequency and what will be the sound carrier frequency, that you can find out. Picture carrier frequency is at a position of 1.25 megahertz, and the sound carrier frequency, you have to add a 5.5 megahertz, that will give you the sound carrier frequency. Now, I will give you the example. Here you can see that bandwidth I have mentioned for a 3 different channel. Correct? So, let us say we have this channel number 5. This is the channel number 5. This is the channel number 6. And this one is the channel number 7. Just now already mentioned that the channel 5 is going to be start with 174 to 181 megahertz. Then channel 6 will start with the 181 megahertz to a 188 megahertz. And channel 7 will start with the 188 megahertz. Now if you add a 7 megahertz, so it will be a 195 megahertz. Every channel has a bandwidth of 7 megahertz. Now I want to find out what is the picture carrier frequency for channel 5, 6 and 7. Same way, what is the sound carrier frequency for the channel number 5, 6 and 7. So here the starting is 174. So this is 174 megahertz, just we have discussed. Then if we add 1.25, this portion is a 1.25, remember, correct? So that will give you a picture carrier frequency 175.75 megahertz. Then if we add 5.5 megahertz, so that will give you the position of your a sound carrier frequency, so it is a 180.75 megahertz. Then we have a guard band of a 0.25 megahertz, and then your next channel is going to be start with the 181 megahertz. Now in 181 megahertz, if I will add a 1.25, so 182.25 megahertz will be the picture carrier frequency for the channel number 6. Now in this, if I will add a 5.5, so it is a 187.75 megahertz, that is the sound carrier frequency. And this channel is going to be end at a 188 megahertz. So, channel 7 is going to be stuck at 188 megahertz. And 188 megahertz, again if I will add a 1.25 megahertz, so it is 189.25 megahertz, that is the position for a picture carrier frequency. And then if we add a 5.5 megahertz, so it is a 194.75 megahertz for the sound carrier frequency. So in this way, we have number of the channels, and this number of the channel has a different picture carrier frequency and a sound carrier frequency. But what you have to remember, that always the sound carrier frequency is that sound carrier is always greater than a picture carrier. By amount of how much? 5.5 megahertz. And between the two channels, there is a guard band of a 0.25 megahertz. Another thing that the picture changes is a amplitude modulated where we use the vestigial sideband. Vestigial sideband means the complete upper sideband frequency is transmitted, but the some portion of a lower sideband is transmitted. Second thing, the sound carrier is always a frequency modulated wave. This is about how the signal, audio information and video information is transmitted. Now let us see what are the different channels we use in the television. So here there is a list of a broadcast channel with the frequency range. Like whatever the electromagnetic spectrum is allocated for the television transmitter, then it is divided in four parts. One of the part is known as a lower VHF. Remember, lower VHF. What is a VHF? VHF means a very high frequency range. And in this very high frequency range, is divided in two parts. One is known as a lower and another is a upper VHF. And accordingly, it is allocated back. So, here lower VHF range is known as a band 1. This band 1 is starting from a 41 megahertz to 68 megahertz. Now in band 1, how many channels will be there? That you can see in this table. That band 1 is there, and in band 1 we have 4 channels, channel number 1, 2, 3 and 4. And I already mentioned that every channel has a bandwidth of a 7 MHz. So here it is starting with the 40 MHz to a 47 MHz, that is the range of a channel 1. But this channel 1 is not used for the television transmission. It is some different application that we are not going to discuss. Then channel 2, we start with the frequency of 47 MHz to 54. Channel 3 is 54 to 61 and channel 4 is 61 to 68. Now if I want to find out what is the picture carrier frequency for the channel 2, so here whatever the lower range is there, you add a 1.25. So 47 plus 1.25, that will give you a picture carrier frequency. In this picture carrier frequency, if we add a 5.5 MHz, that will give you the sound carrier frequency. So in this way, the different picture carrier frequency and the sound carrier frequency are given for the band 1. Then if you see upper VHF range, it is known as a band 3. Band 3 is starting with the frequency of a 174 MHz to 230 MHz. Then what about the band 2? Remember, so in band 2, whatever the frequency range is there, it has some different application. It is used for some different application like a FM radio. You know that FM radio, that it has a frequency from 88 MHz to 108 MHz. So in between, from the 68 to 174, in between whatever the frequency is there, this frequency is allocated to some other application like a FM radio, and also it is used in a military application for a particular radio transmission. It is used. But for the television, the allotted range is from 174 to 230 MHz. Now, this frequency range has number of the channel, which is starting from the channel number 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 to 12. So, the rest of the 8 channels are in a bandwidth 3, in a band 3. And what are the frequency of this? It is already given here, channel 5. Means the frequency range is 174 to 181. So bandwidth is 7 MHz. and this is 175.25 is a picture carrier, and 180.75 is your sound carrier. So in this way, the VHF, whatever the VHF range is there, it has a total 12 channels are there. Then we have more number of the channels, but it is in a UHF range. UHF means it is called an ultra high frequency. And UHF range, we have two bands. One is a band 4, band 5. And this band 4, band 5 is a large frequency range, 470 to 582, and then we have 606 to 790. So it contains a large number of the channels. So in this way, for the television transmission, the VHF ring and the UHF ring are used for the transmission, and we have a large number of the channels in a UHF ring. So this is about the how the frequency spectrum is allocated for the television transmission. In the next video lecture, we will discuss about a block diagram of a television transmitter.